Picture today a surgical scene. Sterile room, bright lights, instruments clean. Patients today know they'll be safe. But lo, long ago, this was not such the case. What once was called surgery was nothing of sort, and began when such things were of desperate resort. From the New Stone Age, 4500 BC, where holes drilled in skulls were the best you would see. With these crude efforts and noble intentions, only turpentine and vinegar might stave off infections. And for these poor patients, through their howls and their groans, nothing there offered eased the slicing of bone. Flash forward some years to the ancient Egyptians, learning of organs through mummifications. 'Twas known that honey kept infection at bay, after their saws and forceps had had their way. The Greeks also made tools for their own resections, and found that wine helped ward off infections. Gladiators thrived with Galen around, who studied the body, slicing on beasts that he'd found. Clearly, surgery before anesthesia was simply barbaric, excruciating pain making patients hysteric. But this was a time to be awake was thought key, to come out alive of your surgery. In India, years later, across all the land, nose upon nose was sliced off by hand. As punishment, yes, but which was the worse? The loss or the cure, nose stitched back with force. Through the Middle Ages, this agony of pain continued, leaving the needy writhing in vain, as concoctions of herbs attempted to mask the unspeakable agony of resolute surgeons' task. Here soon emerged a brand new vocation. Barber surgeons pulled teeth and did amputations. Inside of their shops, your wounds he'd repair, and for a spare shilling, he'd trim up your hair. At this time in large cities emerged a disease that would rot off your face while spreading with ease. Quite the scandal, but surgeons and skin grafts could save you in weeks, though by stitching your arm to the side of your cheek. But here education humbly begins, to improve how surgeons could heal their kin. Though students were faced with dubious terms, forced to steal cadavers, to dissect and to learn. Finally from darkness, a turn that advances, with the arrival of chloroform, ether, and gases, which tamed the edge of all of this pain, though significant risks of dying remained. But then new technologies wrought realizations, like how gloves made of rubber could aid sterilization. And through a germ theory, new insights arrived. Why, simply washing one's hands could help patients survive. So, by the mid-1900s, surgery was safe. Antibiotics having found their true place. Amongst better schooling and doctors who shared the skills, yes, to heal, but also to care. Now the term healthcare means thousands of tasks. Thousands of roles built on the past. And with esteemed institutions teaching what's right, the history of surgery's future is bright.